Hello all of you all. Today let's understand management in practice. All of you would have studied principles of management in your 11th standard and 12th standard. Let me submit to you as a management student, as an MBA and a PhD holder in the field of management, some important rules. The success mantras of management lies in execution. Whatever you do, whatever strategy you plan, whatever business plans you make, ultimately it all boils down to implementation and execution. Unless it is properly executed with timelines and milestones, a plan will remain a plan. It will be on the drawing board. So rule number one, execution is the key once planning is done. As Japanese people say, give maximum time for planning, and once the plan has been formalized, then focus on implementation. So the saying is, if you fail to plan, then you are planning to fail. So plan, number two, execute. Now, what is the skills that somebody should have for successful management? Number one is IQ, which is called as intelligence quotient. Second is EQ, which is emotional quotient. And third is SQ, which is social quotient. IQ can be taught from books. It can be taught by case studies. You can learn. EQ, according to me, can be taught to a certain extent. It is more inborn, or you'll have to develop it beyond the classrooms. Finally, SQ is about teamwork. Here, a leader has to develop skills, because ultimately execution has to be done by a team which has to be properly motivated. Now let's talk about a bit on motivation also. Motivation, a person can be motivated either by money. That's the basic of Maslow's theory. Second, there are some people who would be motivated not by money alone, but along with money, some recognition. So you recognize them among teams as a performer. There's a third type of leaders. There's a third type of team workers who want to do something selflessly for society. And they don't need money or they don't need motivation. They are more internally motivated. So you'll have to judge your team member and accordingly motivate them to performance. And that's the role of a leader. Ultimately, let me also tell you, management is about leadership skills. And a true leader will actually develop other leaders in various fields. The main person need not be a specialist. He can be a generalist, but at the same time, he should have specialists all around him, and he should know how the work should be done in a team. Now, if you look at the big leaders like Bill Gates, Steve Jobs, they all had a vision, and the vision was customer delight. Once they had that vision, they came to execution and they got a team which was far better than them. Each individual was far better than them in their own field. And then with proper teamwork, the success was achieved. That is, in short, the success mantras for successful management. Thank you. All the very best.